Greetings and welcome to Jefficho Films. Today we're going to review a 1980 sci-fi horror cult film with these creatures that are considered to be humanoids. What's the definition of a humanoid? It's just that they have the appearance of a human. You think they're going to be friendly? I think they're going to be friendly, especially when they make contact with mankind. Maybe they'll show us the benefits of living underwater and stuff. Who knows? So let's review Humanoids from the Deep. This movie starts out underwater and we see a really sweet cove, and then we see the small town. It's the fishing village of Noya, California, and Jim says hi to Hank, and Johnny complains about the lack of fish. See, there's a cannery that's going to be opening up possibly, and Hank thinks it's progress. We see a one-legged seagull as the fishermen are chatting, and Deke is committed to this scene, if only the other actors in it were. His son literally puts a gas container upside down.
Oh, it's starting to itch real good, Tommy. We're in for a big run.
But don't shave that shaggy mess until we fill all our holes, okay?
You got it.
Jackie falls in, and judging by the amount of blood, I'm assuming he's dead. And this genius is loading the flare. I'm not sure why. Is he signaling for help?
I gotta save the boy! I gotta get in there!
Take my butt!
Take it!
Nothing you can do.
Well, they can see you now. This is why you don't bring your kid to work. The sheriff talks to Jim at home and they hear a noise, so Jim sends his dog out to investigate, and they literally kill the dog. It's strangled and clawed by a creature. That's a no-no. Bastards. Carol goes to feed the dog the next day and puts some food out, and she gets a cat scare. The locals have a lot of beer, and they find a lot of dead dogs. Jim and Carol head down to the cove, and it looks a lot like the one in The Howling. Because it is. Mystery solved. It's werewolves. Director Joe Dante actually was offered this and went on to do The Howling pretty much at the same time. I guess he saw the location shoots. That night, Peggy Larson is chilling in her sexy underwear doing laundry, and when it falls, it sounds like a sword unsheathing. And then she knocks over some dishes and jumps at that, and then the phone rings. If she jumps at anything else, she is primed for a killing. She grabs a fork, maybe for food, but I think for defense, and she's startled by her boyfriend. She is too scared to fool around.
How are you doing?
You asshole.
The back door was locked. I thought I'd come in the side door.
I guess John Lithgow isn't reverend of this town because there's a town hall dance happening. Thank you, Kevin Bacon, for fighting for our rights. Apparently it's a festival, and we get introduced to a couple of corporate guys and Dr. Susan Drake. And they tell us that they're going to put a cannery in and bring more jobs. And they promise that Susan can make the fish bigger.
Dr. Susan Drake here, great little scientist, has been conducting research at our labs upstream for the last 7 years.
Jim's girlfriend hears something, but we didn't. Johnny comes in carrying his dead dog, and he knows it was Hank, and Hank thinks that Johnny took out everybody else's dog and started killing them. And then we find out Hank's pretty racist, and three guys just tag team and start beating the shit out of him until Jim jumps in. There's some serious fisticuffs.
Jim, look out!
Slater goes out on his little boat with his friends and a gun, and he sneaks onto Johnny's land and eavesdrops on his legal plans. Important stuff here. Jim and Susan are on a boat checking out some marine life while there's some teens on the beach, and Jerry and his girlfriend run off to go fool around because her friend was enjoying watching them. Charlie catches something on his line, but his line breaks, and Susan takes some photos. Why do I suspect she created giant fish creatures? Guys, never go into the water if you want to have sex with your girlfriend. It always leads to getting killed, and Johnny gets killed and his face ripped off, and his girlfriend gets chased down and raped by these creatures. And Linda, feeling abandoned by your friend, runs off with Carol and gets dragged back.
Linda! I'm going down to meet the boat. You want to come?
Hank at the bar tells his bros about Johnny Eagle and his law plans. He wants to take care of Johnny for good and his people. Still pretty racist. Then we meet some weird couple down at the beach with a tent with a ventriloquist dummy, Billy. It must work because she still gets naked and something else. Oh yeah, a creature rips through the tent and takes a chunk out of Billy. Who's moving the dummy's eyes? Because he's like watching this.
Two's company, three's a crowd, Chuck.
He is kind of sexy.
Not as sexy as you are, baby.
The girl runs naked on the beach looking around, but she still manages to run directly into one of the creatures. The annoying sounds the creature makes is pretty bad, and then he jump cut rapes her. Hank and his friends go out on a little boat while Johnny has some friends over talking about his legal plans, and then a creature pokes his head out of the water. Hank Molotov cocktails Johnny's house, but like, bigger explosion.
Tommy, get down!
Send the girl into town with Johnny's truck as Blonde Boy gets pulled under the water and attacked. Hank manages to spear one of the creatures and wound it pretty good, and then another jumps out and he shoots it. The girl's attacked while driving, but she manages to shake it off the truck, and then another appears, and she drives off the bridge and the truck explodes. Still, probably a better alternative than what happened to those other girls. Johnny shows up with Tommy's wounded body, and he tells Susan and the sheriff, sea monsters. Hank says they must have burnt his house too. What a dick. Johnny and Jim and Susan go out looking for evidence, and Jim says Susan knows a lot more than she's letting on. She says the attacks are a pattern of a nocturnal predator. They get to Jim's real boat, the Beverly Jean, and Susan starts drawing one, but Johnny says the head is bigger. Well, now you're just incriminating yourself, Susan. Jim got a call that Tommy's gonna be alright, and Susan spots a cave on the coastline, so they take a little boat ashore, and they find one, and they have to shoot it, and then they get attacked by another one, and they shoot that, and Susan's just taking photos the whole time. They find Peggy covered in seaweed, naked, but still alive. Johnny has to harpoon another creature. Back in Susan's medical lab, she's doing an autopsy and says big head means bigger brain capacity. She says she's been telling them for a while, and then she shows them some DNA footage. She explains they stimulated growth hormones so they could create larger fish fast. They lost a bunch of them that went into the ocean, and her company doesn't want people to find out. She thinks a prehistoric fish fed on the salmon and evolved 4 stages, and they want to mate with women to further the evolution. Yeah, baby, that's what it's for. We're furthering the evolution. Back in town, it seems like the festival's still going on, and there's a pretty perverted radio announcer.
And we're playing records, and we're just doing a whole lot of things. Listen, if you got a phone, why don't you give me a call? I'd love to talk to you. But I can't talk to you for too long. I may have my hands full.
Jim shows up with a sea monster, and then they all break through the docks and start attacking. Everybody starts running around in a panic, and we see it doesn't pay to be on roller skates. Carol's at home in the shower. I don't know if that's important, but here's some footage. Jim gets Susan to spray gasoline into the water, and the radio guy has the ability to broadcast while not using the radio, and Carol's at home listening to all this while he gets killed. The girl who won the Miss Salmon Award fights one off, and then her top is off, and then on, and then off, and then on again. I call that lazy perv editing. Susan lights the fire as Hank is attacked rescuing a girl. Johnny helps him. Probably shouldn't. Spots of the water are on fire as this plague of monsters continues to attack the people. The townspeople learn that there's strength in numbers and start fighting back. We see that Susan's got a nice bum, and Jim, he's gonna take his boat home to his wife. the baby in the closet and grabs a knife. As the creatures are stalking the house, multiple fishmen attack, aim for the brain. She manages to jump cut kill one, and then Jim shows up and almost eats a knife. The next day, everybody's just hanging out at the fairgrounds while Susan's at the hospital delivering Peggy's baby, but it comes out of her stomach instead. The end. The creatures looked good, and clearly, they're still out there. And I can see the cult appeal of this movie, but I wouldn't put it above Galaxy of Terror or Forbidden World, even if Amazon's trying to put it into their steel box collection. Doug McClure played Jim Hill. He's a bit of a legend, been around for some time, doing a lot of good cult movies. And Aaron Turkel, who played Susan, was pretty good in this. She was in Deep Space, you know, 8 years after this, so maybe we'll get to that. Roger Corman had discussed his plans for this, where these creatures would kill all men and rape all women, but they would go shadowy and cut away and wouldn't show too much. But second unit director James Sabeliti, who later directed Deathstalker, was hired to enliven the film, and he filmed all the explicit rape scenes. Once Peeters and Turkel saw the explicit rape scenes, they kind of asked for their names to be removed from the films, but got denied.
Jim tells me he's going to be taking you for a little pleasure fishing.
Yeah, I even picked out a rod and reel for you tomorrow.
Sweet of you.
And apparently there's a remake that was done in 1996 by Roger Corman. Didn't even know about that. Might have to check it out. Might be worse.
Hey, Jimbo, what do you think about this gal? Gonna do great things, huh?
I believe it when I see it.
You'll see it.
In the end, critics really shit on this movie, but what don't they shit on? This is exactly what this movie wanted to be. Creatures genetically created to evolve into something that was big enough to fight humans. They didn't do a really good job once the humans realized they could team up and attack the creatures. Totally outnumbered. These creatures, they should attack better at night. I mean, they couldn't even kill Carol. That's pathetic, guys. So, check it out, guys. It's a lot of fun to watch, and it is a cult classic. So, thanks for watching. Ah!